What is up, guys? Moon360 is back with another video, and this time we are reviewing the Android 6.0.1 Marshmallow update for the Samsung Galaxy Note 5. I just got it on my UAE variant, but I believe most of the Note 5 models, including those on the various carriers here in the States, have had received the update already earlier this month. The update was about 1.5 gigabytes in size and installed pretty quickly, actually. Took me about 20 minutes to complete the whole process. And the update did breathe in some much needed fresh air to the Note. Right off the bat, you can go to the system settings, about device, software info, and you can see the Android version number 6.0.1, and with it the most up-to-date March 1st Android security patch. Tapping the version number activates the new Easter egg for Marshmallow, and we can play the all-new Flappy Bird game, now complete with marshmallows. The biggest change you'll notice is definitely in the visuals. Samsung updated its TouchWiz skin to look much more modern. You'll get a nice white background when you pull down the notification bar, and more fluid transitions are embedded within this version of Android. For instance, you get a smoother transition when you open and close apps to make the experience less abrupt. Slick transitions are now everywhere in the operating system. You can see them when you open the app drawer, when you slide down the notification bar, and when you launch your recent apps. Many of the system applications are updated as well to reflect the Marshmallow look. Samsung did also bundle in new apps with the update, and they are three Microsoft apps: Excel, PowerPoint, and Word. Fortunately, they can be turned off relatively easily if you don't plan on using them. And of course, the hallmark feature of Android Marshmallow is Google Now on Tap. It's a great feature because with Now on Tap, you can get quick information without leaving the app you're using by holding the home button. And this asks Google to use what's on your screen to show you related details, apps, and actions. So for example, if I go to one of my Hangout conversations and hold down the home button, it looks like it's taking a screenshot, but it's simply recording or scanning everything that's on the screen. And so Now on Tap gave us all the relevant results because we were discussing the Republican debate, and it makes sense for Google to spit back some info in regards to the candidates involved, like Donald Trump, for example, and you can easily follow him on social media or search him in depth on Google. So that's how Untap works, and the more you use it, the more you'll like it and find it resourceful. The next major feature is the Granular App Permissions. Now you can deny or allow specific permissions on an app-by-app basis by going to the Settings, Applications, Application Manager, which allows you to see the full list of apps. Let's use Snapchat as an example. Tap on Permissions to see the permissions Snapchat is granted, and if you really don't want Snapchat to access your messages, just deny the SMS permission like that. Tap it again if you want Snapchat to have that permission again. So that's really about it for this video. All in all, a fantastic update for the Galaxy Note 5 to really make it just as new as the Galaxy S7 and some of Samsung's other newer phones. And all of the changes and additions are extremely welcomed, in my opinion. So if you are a Galaxy Note 5 owner, definitely consider heading over to your settings to grab the update. What do you guys think about Android Marshmallow? Has your phone received a Marshmallow update? I would love to hear it from you guys in the comments section down below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you shortly. Take care.